I'm McDougall, and I'm here on Nick Lindsay's Cook All Night. I got a show up in here in Seattle tonight, and before we head over there, okay, that doesn't work because it's supposed to be called Cook All Night, and we're doing it early in the day. Let's start that over. All right, I'm McDougall, and this is Nick Lindsay's Cook All Night, and tonight I'm going to be making for you some broiled hook and line caught Alaskan coho salmon bellies and collars. Little bit about the bellies and collars. It's not a very good looking cut of fish, but let me tell you, it's one of the tastiest. And there's a lot of fat going on up in that region, and so it just brings out a really good flavor in the fish, and you hardly have to do anything to it. So we're gonna start off with this. I'm gonna come over here. We wanna open up our bag here. Let's try not to cut the microwave while we do that. Let's bring this over here. Normally you use baking sheet, but what we have today is a rack covered in tin foil. So we're just gonna lay these out here. And we are going to do a style of cooking on these that in Japanese is called shioyaki. And basically all we're going to do to these is put salt on them and let them sit for about a half an hour. And then we're going to throw them in that oven. Unroll. Well, this fish is salmon. This particular fish was just purchased in a package. Didn't really come across this fish in any particularly interesting way. The dish, yeah. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
The dish is, I can't think right now. I found this preparation online. And the fish we get through Know Thy Food, which is down in Portland. It's a really cool small market down there that you can get a lot of really great stuff through at a reasonable price. Now, we've got our fish out. Now we're just gonna add some salt. Now Nick, where do you put the salt?
Should be some in there.
You filming this?
Yep.
Seriously, dude?
Oh yeah, it's all.
What is this? Did you buy this at an antique store? So we've got some salt, as it were. We're gonna go ahead and we can be liberal with this. Just want to get that salt. Maybe we should be doing it this way. Salt all over our fish. Normal salt isn't as clumpy as this, but Nick gets a real special bit, special salt. We're just gonna kind of massage that in, as per the shioyaki style. Now, we're just gonna let this sit for a half an hour before we go put it into our oven. And while we do that, we'll go ahead and get the rice started. Today is the elite rice cooker. But we gotta plug this in over here. And we're gonna be rocking some brown rice today. There's a few of us eating, so we're gonna go ahead and do a couple cups. Some people wash their rice before using it, but from what I've been, what I've read, there are a lot of minerals and whatnot that are good for you, and all that starch on the outside. So I just leave that. Person makes it a little more sticky, but whatever.
get over it. You know?
Shoot, let's just go 3 cups.
Why not? Let's go all the way.
I wouldn't recommend with this rice cooker going more than 3 cups because that's actually its capacity. So we're gonna go ahead and fill this up to the 3 cup mark on there with some fresh Seattle water. Minutes to put our fish in the oven. We're gonna go ahead and play some music.
Cool.
Here we go. This was written together with a friend of mine, Michelle. I don't know how to say her name, her maiden name, as it were. Schumbato. Schumbato. Anyways, here we go. Jimmy taught me of angels, and Tommy taught me how to get by, and that fat kid down the street taught me how to bleed out of my left eye. But nothing taught me more than what I saw standing in that line. I saw a murder down at the liquor store last night, and all I wanted was wine. But wine has become my closest friend at the age of 85. Second only comes that liquor store clerk and his sweetheart of a wife. Well, I asked him, friend, are you alright? He just closed his eyes and with his hands declined. I saw murder down at the liquor store last night, and all I wanted was wine. Friend I've had since junior high. I even called upon that cousin who would rather see me die. Cause I don't intend to die alone, like that man who never made it to the payphone. I saw murder down at the liquor store last night, and all I wanted was wine. Sometimes even the tough ones cry. But nothing taught me more than what I saw standing in that line. I saw a murder down at the liquor store last night, and all I wanted was wine. I saw a murder down at the liquor store last night, and all I wanted was wine. All right, well, we're back. We've had our fish sitting out. Now what we want to do, you can just take a look at that fish. What we have here, let's just go ahead and look at these for a second here. We've got these collar pieces, and what we also have are these belly pieces. And both of these, you can just see that fat in there just lining through there so nicely. So that's why, you know, we can treat these so delicately. We don't have to put much on them. We're gonna go ahead and get our oven. We're gonna dial that all the way up. We're gonna go as far as we can and then click it right into that broil position. That's what we're going to want to do to get it to start broiling. Our rice is looking pretty good over here in our rice cooker. Probably shouldn't take the lid off of that just yet. Interesting thing about rice cookers is that prior to those, there was no way to cook rice. So just be thankful that we have these days. Real cheap, get them at the store, 12 bucks. You'll eat rice for the rest of your life. So now, we're just gonna wash our knife because we have nothing else to do for a couple minutes while this heats up. Get this salt put away. Back to the museum, maybe. and get our... Basically, I'm just going to put this stuff in the sink for Nick to wash later. Let's check out that oven, shall we? Yeah, it's not quite ready yet. Wasn't expecting this, but let's just go ahead and shut it down for a minute, and then we'll come back to this. Put it in the oven. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Let's do that again.
What am I, where am I starting? All right, well, we get it. Well, our oven's... Okay, well, our oven's heating up here, getting ready to broil these bad boys. Let's just go ahead and play another song. Okay, yeah, not really. That's not what we're gonna do. Again, I don't have a name for this one. Okay, we've got our oven ready. You want to take a look at that, Nick?
Yeah.
We're gonna just slide. Oh! No, we're not. We
you
are
should
not
be able to fit it the other way.
Gonna
though.
Slide. I don't. I hope so, Nick.
I've done it before.
Oh. Woo! That was gonna be bad. So let's just wait on those. Our rice is gonna be ready by the time those. We're gonna do 7 minutes on that side. We're gonna watch it though, and actually what we want to do is if we can, we're gonna prop this open a little bit and let the steam come out of the oven. And just a little word to the wise, in some homes that might set off your smoke detector. So if you do have a fan, if you could just look up here, Nick, just this fan, we're gonna want to switch that on to high. Cool. So let's Let's do one more while we've got this cooking, and then we'll come back and flip that fish. I think it's time to take our fish out. We already flipped it halfway through at about 7 minutes, and then I really only let it go a little bit longer now that we've got that nice char on the top. And Nick, I want you to get close up on this and see all that nice fat from the fish just bubbling up there, and that's what's going to make this a really flavorful. And one thing I did not mention about this earlier is that the great thing about bellies and collars is that they are way cheaper than buying like fish fillets. So, and I would say a little more flavorful. So, highly recommend it. And so there we have it. Really, we've got our collars. We'll get this all up on a plate soon here. But actually, let's just do that right now. Why not, right? A nice white plate here. You want to be real careful getting this off. In fact, you might want to let it rest again, but we're not going to do that right now just because of time. But that fat is really hot, so you'd be really, really careful pulling that off. Whew. You want to burn the hands, you know, got to play more shots. And let's just give you a little show of the goodness here. As you just look at this meat here. Now look at that. Just comes right off there. And it's gonna slide. See, this is all cartilage, so people get afraid to eat this. But then when you cook it up, it's so fatty and nice, it's like ribs. It's just gonna come right off that bone. So there you have it. Salmon bellies and collars with McDougall. We'll sweaty? Am I obviously sweaty?
Yep.
I better put the hat on.
It's all good though, it makes it dramatic.
Yeah, that's true.